Please tell me, why are you here today?
To come here to vote. Yeah.
Who did you vote for?
Tsai Ing-wen.
Okay.
And are you happy about the result?
Very happy.
Over expectation, really.
Yeah.
Okay, well, how about you come first and let me know how you feel about this.
So,
can you come up a little bit? Yes, and can you please introduce yourself a little bit?
So, hi, I'm from Taiwan, but I basically came back from the United States to vote for our next president. So I'm really excited to see the result, like now.
Can you tell me why you decided to go back and vote for Tsai Ing-wen?
So, from what we know, like before the result came out, we basically think that there's a really dangerous situation for our democracy. And we saw the protests in Hong Kong, and we feel really scared about our future, the future of this country. So that's the reason why a lot of us came back from the United States to vote for our future.
I see.
I also came back today for a vote, and I only stay about 3 days. Yeah, because I was afraid another party will win the election, and they have good relationship with China. So I don't want that to be happen. So that's why I came back.
So to you, as a young person, a young generation, what is the most important issue to the young generation of Taiwanese right now?
I think freedom, yeah, and democracy, and we can decide who to be our next leader to the country.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to interview you now then.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
So you say you also come back from Switzerland, right?
Yeah. So I currently study my PhD studies in Switzerland and just came back for votes, yeah. And for this question, I think the motivation comes from the anxiety brought by the opposite campaign. And also like the decay of our democracy. It's like anxiety we brought up when I basically work alone abroad. Yeah. So that's why it motivates me. Yeah.
You brought up the opposing candidate, you mean Han Kuo-yu, right?
Yeah.
What is your opinion of him?
It's more like he just brought up some bad, like the darkest side of democracy itself. Yeah, because the democracy itself is not solid at all. I mean, especially in Taiwan, which is a young democracy, a democratic country. Yeah, so we are afraid these kind of thinking, this kind of mindset would just directly turn over back to Taiwan, this country. Yeah.
Can I please interview you,
yeah.
The gentleman?
I probably need to hide my face because I work in a country just next to us, so you know why. Yeah.
And what country is that?
The People's Republic of China, yeah.
And how long have you been working in mainland China?
For a couple years, yeah. So I think the reason why we come back, actually a lot of friends of mine working in the same city, we come back. There are several reasons. I think one is that because we work there, so we know what is the reality of what's going on, what the people are saying in Taiwan. Because a lot of people will say that China is really good in some place, in economy, in a lot of places, but actually it's not. Actually, this country is having a lot of issue, and I think because we know and we see all of this, and so we want to come back to make sure our Taiwanese future are still in this, you know, the way that we want to live, in the democracy and freedom way.
You have lived in mainland China for several years.
Yeah, yeah.
Can you tell me the main difference between the difference of freedoms, the level of freedoms and democracy between mainland China and Taiwan?
Yeah, I think the most important ones definitely is that people can decide what they want to people can decide what they want in the society. They can voice out and they have the right to choose what people they like or they believe to be their leader. Yeah, so I think the most different thing is that in Taiwan, the people we have the choice, and people is the actually the owner of this country, but at that place, people is not. Yeah, the government is the owner of the country, and they say whatever they want to say. Yeah.
And And do you imagine this kind of scene, this kind of atmosphere when people come together and rally for a political candidate? Do you think that ever happened in China?
Yes, I do believe in some maybe rural regions, because I do believe there will be some, because that is your human nature. If you want to voice out, you will find some way to voice out. But I think at that place, a lot of news, you cannot see it, and the government will basically just, you know, just cover all the news. So I do believe that people are voicing out in that in there, but it was not shown in the news, or it was not being known by other people. Yeah.
But at this large scale of a presidential election like this.
No. They don't. Basically, they don't have this kind of structure, like government structure. So that's not gonna happen. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much. Yeah. And may I ask the gentleman from Seattle? Thank you. So how long have you lived in America?
About 4.5 years.
Four and a half years?
Yeah.
So do you see that there's a strong influence from the Western culture, the idea of democracy and freedoms in the Taiwan culture? And especially, do you think it's imprint strongly on the mindset of the young generation?
I definitely think so. And I also think the relationship between Taiwan and America has been improving throughout the past three and four years because of the leader we have. So we're here to support her. And then we want the Taiwan to move towards the right direction.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you.
And may I invite some of the gentlemen from the back or some lady?
I'm from Taiwan.
Come on.
Your turn.
Hi.
Okay, so yesterday the other 2 days ago, I went to the KMT rally and met a young student who said that he support Hong Kuo Yu.
Oh, yeah?
Okay. And he said that, well, China is the biggest trading partner with Taiwan, and second is Japan. And then Taiwan also have a really good relationship with United States. Why is no one asking the question that, are we pro-Japan? Are we too pro-America? Why is it always about...
focus on China?
Yes. So what is your take on that?
Basically...
Would you like to stand in the middle a little bit?
Yeah. Yes. Because if, such as Japan and America, we trade equally country to country, that's we face country to country to the same part. But it comes to China, it becomes we're not a country anymore. We're just part of them. So there's not, we can't face the equality for trading or any kind of politics things or economic things.
Do you think there's a bit of a threat coming from China, since Xi Jinping, the president of People of Republic of China, actually threatened to use forces to unify the country, including Taiwan. Do you think there's a real threat from that, and that affect the votes of the young people?
Yeah, in our opinion, it is. So, such as Hong Kong and Xinjiang, yeah, it's something that we can see maybe might happen in the future. So that's why this vote is so important for our generation. Yeah.
Thank you. Anyone else want to add anything?
Oh, don't fade out.
Yeah, don't fade out, guys. Come back.
I should go to find my mother because it's already 8:30.
Yes. I was about to tell you to reach her.
Okay,
come reach her. Okay. is it
your first time going to vote for a president in Taiwan?
Second time.
When first won the election 4 years ago, were you surprised? Did you support her during that time?
Yes.
I support her.
Some people say she's like the symbol of independence of Taiwan. Do you agree with that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think, but it's also like a symbol of the way of Taiwanese, the democracy itself.
I think it's more about the core of progressive, because they have proved a lot of laws that is, I think for the society, it's more like a long-term benefit, progressive.
I think a lot of people said she represents independence of Taiwan, but I think the reason why people think that is because we only have two really big parties. Yeah. So like one is for China and the other is in, so either or, so we have to choose one, right? We have to choose the one that can save our future. So that is the thing, the reason why a lot of people vote for Tsai Ing-wen. It's not really because we support independent, because we also like, we want to maintain the good relationship with China. We don't want to like destroy all of it. We don't hate Chinese people. We just don't think that the threats from them is a good thing for us. Yeah.
Can you tell me what is the biggest difference between a Taiwanese? What makes a Taiwanese and what make a mainland Chinese?
So actually, as you mentioned about the pro-independent, but in fact, Taiwan is a sovereign state. I mean, no matter in any definition, it's a sovereign state. And we have our own system, our own government, our own army, and our like currency, and also our way of life. And that's what's built us, I mean, to be Taiwanese. Like the natural belief in democracy and like election, why we are here, and also the right for people to vote, and the freedom of speech, and all of the press. Yeah.
So despite the similarity in culture, despite the similarity in the language, and even in the cuisine and anything, a lot of things, even you have some part of the history, that doesn't mean that you want to
just
be.
Just take for example, like the United States and the UK. British. They speak English, but they are totally different. So that's just how simple it is.
And just like where I work, like in Switzerland, we have a German speaking part, but they also think themselves as a Swiss people rather than German. Yeah.
So any last thing you would like to add or tell our audience?
For future.
Yeah. So
young people, please come out. You don't come out this time, you needed to come out the next time, 4 years later.
So always just speak up for yourself.